empty set. What is an empty set? Already we have discussed in the previous class. What is an empty set? If the set does not contain any element, then the set is called empty set. For example, if I say to write the set, if I give a set in the form like this, A is equal to x such that x is a whole number, x is a whole number less than 0. This one is set in the form x such that x is a whole number less than 0. Okay. So if I say you're writing set, this is a set in the form. If you write this one in roaster form, you say what is the number which is less than 0? What is the whole number which is less than 0 here? What are the whole numbers first? Whole numbers start from 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Okay. So whole number starts from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Here the least number is 0. But they are asking write the number which is less than 0. So here any number is not there which is less than 0. So here there is no element. There is no whole number which is less than 0. So there is no element in the set. Whenever there is no element in the set, what you have to write? You have to use like this. That means empty set. Anything is not there inside the bracket. Any element is not present. Okay. Otherwise, you have to write 5. But don't keep 5 in the set. If you keep like this, then it contains one element. The element is 5. It becomes an element. So we should not keep like this. Like this. Okay. Either we have to write empty set like this or like this. Now, what is the cardinal number of A? Cardinal means what? Number of elements. N of A. Number of elements of A. How many elements are there in A? In set A? No elements are there. So, I have to keep 0 elements are there in the set A. Empty set is also called, we can call empty set as void set. Empty set is also called as void set or null set. Null means what? Nothing will be there. Did you understand? If the set does not contain any element, otherwise if the cardinal number of the set is 0, then the set is called empty set or void set or null set. Another example of empty set. You see another example of empty set. A is equal to x such that x is a natural number between 3.1 and 3.5. Okay, between 3.1 and 3.5, how many numbers will be there? How many rational numbers will be there? So many numbers will exist. 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, 3.11, 3.12, 3.13. So many numbers will be there between 3.1 and 3.5. But they are asking, what is x? X is a natural number between 3.1 and 3.5. That means, between 3.1 and 3.5, which natural number is there? So there is no natural number between 3.1 and 3.5. So there is no element in this set. So what you have to write? A is a null set. A is a null set. Null set means it does not contain any element. Fine. Now what is the cardinal number of A? Cardinal number you write as N of A. Number of elements in set A is equal to 0 elements. If you understand what is an empty set? If the set does not contain any element, then it is called empty set. Otherwise, if the cardinal number of the set is 0, then it is called empty set. Did you understand, children, what is empty set? Next one. Universal set and subset. Very important. Universal set and subset. What is universal set? What is subset? For example, if you take A is a set of natural numbers. What are the natural numbers? 1, 2, These are the set of natural numbers. Okay. Now I will make some sets by using these numbers. Okay. For example, I take only two numbers, 1, 2. This is also a set. Okay. What is the cardinal number of this set? We cannot say the cardinal number of this set because how many elements are there? We don't know. But here, by using these elements, I am preparing some sets. Here 1, 2 I took and I prepared a set. So the cardinal number of this set is 2. Then n of b is equal to 2. Next, and I am making 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So how many elements are there? 6 elements are there. So by using these numbers, I prepared one set. Next, 3, 5, 7. Did you understand? Next, E. 6, 7, 8. Yeah, only one element I am taking, 9. Did you understand what I am doing here? These elements only I am taking. Some elements I am taking and I am creating the new set. Now, what do you understand from this? Here, which elements are there? That elements are present in set A. These elements are present in set A. But these elements are not present in set B. All elements of A does not contain in set B. But all the elements of set B contains in set A. And all the elements of set C are present in set A. But all the elements of set A does not present in set C. All the elements of set D are present in set A. All the elements of set E are present in set A. Next, all the elements of set F are present in set A. So, what we will say, this set is called as universal set. Let me give you the biggest set here. Universal set. This is the universal set. What are these? These are called subsets. All the sets. These are all called as subsets. These are all called as subsets. Did you understand subsets means what? So, we are taking the set which contains all the elements of the given set. Okay. Then, the set is subset of the given set. That means here, B contains all. So, did you understand what is a subset? What is a subset? If this set contains some elements of the given set. Okay. Then, this set is said to be subset of the given set. Here, see. B contains some elements of the given set. Some elements. 1, 2. So, this is the subset. B is subset of A. And here, C contains some elements of the given set. So, C is subset of A. And D contains some elements of given set. So, D is subset of A. In the same way, E contains some elements of given set. So, E is subset of A. F is also subset of A. How you write here? B is subset of A. C is subset, this is subset, C is subset of A, D is also subset of A, E is also subset of A, F is also subset of A. So, these are all called subsets. Did you understand? So, these sets contain some elements of the given set. So, this is the universal set. So, A is the universal set, B, C, D, E and F are the subsets of given set. Did you understand? Now, what is singleton set? What is singleton set? If the set contains only one element, then it is called singleton set. Only one element. If the set contains only one element, then it is called singleton set. For example, if I give you a condition, A is equal to X such that X is a natural number. X is a natural number less than 2. So, this is the segmented form. Now, you have to convert this one into rostered form. So, what is the rostered form of this? X such that X is a natural number less than 2. What is the natural number less than 2? Only we have one natural number less than 2. What is that number? 1. So, how many elements it contains? one element. So this is called singleton set. What is singleton set? If the set contains, if the cardinal number of the set is 1, then it is called singleton set. For example, if you write 5, this is also singleton set because this is 5 is an element in the set. But if you write 5 like this, this is not a singleton set, just it is an empty set. For example, if you write 0, 0 is the element in the set. So, number of elements is 1. So, it is also a singleton set. Did you understand what is singleton set? Next. Did you understand different set types of sets? Empty set, universal set, subset, and what? What is the last set we discussed? Singleton set. Okay. Next. Now we go to operation of sets. Operation of sets. Already have some basic operations: addition, subtraction, multiplication, division. Then what will happen if you do addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, you get some number as the result. Okay, in the same way here also some operations are there. Okay, what are they? First one, union of sets. Union of sets. Second one, intersection of sets. Union of sets. Second one, intersection of sets. Third one, difference of sets. Difference of sets. We have these operations. So let us see how to perform these operations of sets. First, let us discuss union of sets. Okay? We will discuss union of sets. Union means what? For example, if you take two sets, if you perform the operation union, again you get one set as the result. That is operation of set. That means we are doing some operation. Here we will see what is union of sets. Union is denoted by the symbol U. What is the separator form of A union B? For example, you take any two sets. Let A and B are any two sets. Let A and B are any two sets. You take any two sets. Then if you do union, then A union B is equal to, what is A union B? X such that X belongs to A or X belongs to B. That means X such that X is an element which is present in set A or set B. It may present in set A or set B. Okay. This is a set builder form of A union B. Very, very important. The set builder form is very, very important. Based on this, we will solve the sums. Okay, we will see. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. B is equal to 3, 5, 6, 2. A and B are two sets. Now I will perform A union B. Okay, A union B. A is what? 1, 2, 3, 4. Union. B is what? 3, 5, 6, 2. See here, what I did? A. I wrote set A. Union. I wrote union. This is the symbol of union. A union B. Or A cup B. Okay? And B. I wrote set B. Now what I told? If you do this operation, you get one result. That result is also again a set. Okay, now what I told, what is A union B? X such that. That means you take the elements from the set. What you have to take, it may belongs to A or it may belongs to A or it may belongs to B. That means it is present in both. We can take elements from set A and set B also. First you take elements which are present in set A. First I take 1, 2, 3, 4. Completed. I took the elements from set A. Now I am taking the elements from set B. should not be repeated. Already here, see here, 2 is repeated 2 times and 3 is repeated 2 times. So that is wrong. What we have to do, before only I told, the elements in the set should not be repeated. So what we have to write? First we have to write the set A as this. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Next what we have to take? 3. 3. You take the elements from set B. 3. 3 already exists. So you should not write second time. So don't write. Next 5. 5 is not there. Write 5. Next 6. 6 already there. Not there. 6 already. 6 is not there in the set A. So I have to write 6. Next 2. 2 already exists in set A. So already we wrote here 2. So you close the bracket. So this is A union B. We should not repeat the elements. This is wrong. Okay. Next. N of A union B. N of means what? Number of elements in A union B. How many elements are there in A union B? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So the cardinal number of A union B is 6. Now, we will take another example. Okay, let P is equal to x such that x is an even number. X is an even number less than 10. P is equal to x such that x is an even number less than 10. Q is equal to x such that x is a natural number less than 5. This is the set-builder form because condition is given. You convert the set-builder form to roster form first. What is P? X is an even number less than 10. What are the even numbers less than 10? 2, 4, 6, 8. Q is equal to x such that x is the natural number less than 5. So what are the natural numbers less than 5? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now what we have to do? We have to write P union Q. What is P? 2, 4, 6, 8. Union. What is Q? 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, see here, P union Q. What I have to write? First write the elements of set P. What are the elements of set P? 2, 4, 6, 8. Now, we write the elements of set Q. Already, first you have to take 1. 1 is not present in set P, right? 2 is present in set P. No need to write again. 3 does not present in set P. So, write 3. 4, it is present in set P. So, close. If you want to write, you can write it. Order 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8. N of P union Q. That means number of elements in P union Q. How many elements are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Total, there are 6 elements in P union Q. Did you understand? This is union of set. Did you understand, children, what is union of set? Union of set means you have to take the elements from A as well as from B also. From the two sets, you have to take the elements. If any element is repeated two times, you have to write only once. You should not write two times the elements. Next, second operation, intersection of sets. Intersection of sets. Okay, intersection of sets is denoted by the symbol like this. This is the symbol of intersection. Okay, so what is the set builder form of intersection of sets? Let A and B such that x belongs to A and x belongs to B. Now we will solve the sums. I am giving two sets. A is equal to, directly I am giving the elements of the set. 3, 5, 6, 7. B is equal to 6, 7, 8, 9. I gave two sets. Okay. Now what I have to do? I have to perform intersection here. A intersection B. First write the set A. 3, 5, 6, 7. Intersection. What is B? 6, 7, 8 and 9. Total. Yeah, I know. Now, what is A intersection B? X such that X belongs to A and X belongs to B. What is the meaning of and? And means it belongs to both the sets. It should present in A as well as B also. The element should belong to both the sets. Okay. You will see. 3 is present in A but is not present in B. So we cannot say 3 is present in A and B. We cannot say like that. 5 is present in only set A. 6 is present in A and B also. Common elements. Intersection is nothing but common elements. You have to take a common elements. Intersection means only common elements you have to take. What is the meaning of and? And means it should present in both. It should present in both means you have to take the common elements. So 6 is present in both. So write 6. Next, 7 is present in both set A and B. Right? 7. Completed. Here 8 is present in only B. It is not present in A. 9 is present in only B. It is not present in A. What do you understand? Intersection means what? The element should belong to both the sets. Here 6 presents in both A and B. 7 present in both A and B. So number of elements of A intersection B. Number of elements in A intersection B. How many elements are there? Only 2 elements are there in A intersection B. Did you understand? What is A intersection B? The element should be present in both the given sets. Okay. Let us see next example. So I gave one subbuilder form. S is equal to X such that X belongs to Z, where minus 1 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 2. And T is equal to X such that X is equal to N square, where N belongs to N and N less than 4. This gives S is equal to X belongs to Z. So I have to take integers. What they gave? Minus 1 less than or equal to X less than or equal to 2. You see this one? X. First minus 1 less than or equal to X. X you write this side, minus 1 you write this side. Then less than becomes greater than, equal to will be equal to 1. And here X is less than or equal to 2. So you have to take X should be greater than or equal to minus 1. That means minus 1 onwards. Greater than numbers you have to take 0, 1 up to 2. So what is set S? Minus 1, 0, 1, 2. What is set T? T means, what is set T here? X is equal to N square. X is equal to N square. What is the n? N belongs to n. N is a natural number. In the place of n, you have to take natural number. Up to where you have to take n value less than 4. Less than 4 means up to 3 you have to take. 1 square. So 1. 2 square. 4. 3 square. 9. So you write S intersection T. S intersection T. Okay. S intersection T. Intersection S means what? Minus 1, 0, 1, 2. Intersection T. What is the set of T? 1, 4, 9. Now you check what are the common elements in both. Minus 1 is present only in set S, not in T. 0 also not present in both the sets. 1 is present in both the sets. So write 1. 9, 2 is present only in this set. It is not present in the set. So it contains only one element. Number of elements in S intersection T is 1. That means this type of set is called singleton set. Did you understand what is intersection of two sets? The element should be belongs to both the sets. That means you have to take common element. Did you understand? Now last. inside. What is that? Disjoint sets. Disjoint. What are disjoint sets? Let us take A is equal to 1, 2, 3. B is equal to 4, 5, 6. Now if I do A intersection B, intersection means what? Common elements.
Here, which elements are common here? 1 is present in both? No. 2 is not present in both. 3 is not present in both the sets. So, nothing is common in A and B. So, here, it is an empty set because no element is common. It is also represented as 5. Did you understand? What are disjoint sets? You take any two sets. If you do intersection of the two sets, if no element is common, if there is no element in common, then the type of sets are called disjoint sets. So here A and B are disjoint. Disjoint means what? There is no common element in both the sets. Okay. So N of A intersection B. Number of elements in A intersection B. How many elements are there? 0. Did you understand? So the number of elements in A intersection B is 0. If two sets are disjoint sets, the number of elements in A intersection B is 0. Did you understand? These are disjoint sets. What are disjoint sets? If nothing is common, if no element is common in both the sets, then the type of sets are called disjoint sets. Next, last and final, difference of sets. Difference of sets. Very, very important. Difference means what? Already you know, difference means a subtraction. So, minus here. Let A and B are any two sets. Then A minus B is equal to X such that X belongs to A and X does not belong to B. Now B minus A. X such that X belongs to B and X does not belong to A. This is very, very important. Okay. Here difference means you have A minus B and B minus A. You take any two sets. If you do A minus B, what is A minus B? X such that X belongs to A. X should be present in A, but it should not be present in B. That means it should be present in the first set. It should not present in the second set. B minus A means what? It should present in the first set B. X belongs to B and X does not belong to A. It should not present in set A. Now I'll take one question. A is equal to 5, 6, 7, 8. B is equal to 7, 8, 9, 10. Now I'll do A minus B. A minus B. What is A? 5, 6, 7, 8. Minus 7, 8, 9, 10. See here, what is A minus B? X such that we have to take the element which is present in A but does not present in B. So 5 is present only in A, it does not present in B. 5 is not there in B. So I have to write 5. 6. It is present only in A. It is not present in B. Next. 7. It is present in A as well as B also. 7 is present in both the sets. So what is the condition? It should present in only in A set. It does not present in B set. It should not be present in the set B. But here 7 is present in A as well as in B also. So we should not write 7. 8 is present in A as well as in B. So we should not write 8 also. And 9 and 10 we should not write because the condition is the element should be present in set A, not in set B. So you have to stop. Did you understand? So how many elements are there in A? A minus B, total 2 elements are there. What is A minus B? The element should be present in set A. It should not be present in set B. That means if you remove the common elements, what is left in set A? That is A minus B. Now we go to B minus A. What is
X belongs to B and X does not belongs to A. It should present in set B. It should not present in set A. Here you take 7. 7 is presenting A, B as well as A. So you should not take this. 8 is present in B as well as A. You should not take this also. 9 is present only in B. It is not present in A. You have to take 9. 10 is present only in B. It is not present in A. So you have to take 10. Number of elements in B minus A is equal to 2. So every time A minus B is never equal to B minus A. That means A minus B set never equal to B minus A. Okay. We'll take one more example. A is equal to X such that, okay, we'll take direct elements. Otherwise, X such that X is a perfect square. X is a perfect square less than 10. Less than 10. B is equal to X such that X is a perfect cube. Less than 15. Okay. Now write the set. A is equal to X such that X is a perfect square. What are the squares? 1 square. 1. 2 square. 4 squares. Perfect squares means that one. 3 square. 9. 4 square. 16. But the real condition less than 10. So up to 9 you have to write. Next. B is equal to X such that X is a perfect cube less than 15. Cube, 1 cube, 1. 2 cube, 8. 3 cube, 27. 27 will be more less than 15. They give condition. 27 is more than 15. So we should not take 27. Now what is A minus B? A, what is the set A? 1, 4, 9. Minus, what is set B? 1 and 8. A minus B means what? The element should be present in A, but it should not present in B. You take the common element, it is present in both. 1 is present in A and B. 4 is present only in A, it is not present in B. So you have to write 4. 9 is present only in A, not present in B. Now B minus A. B minus A. 1, 8, minus 1, 4, 9. B minus A means first you have to write the set B. Minus, next you have to write set A. So, 1 present in both. But it should present only in B. It should not present in both. 8 only present in B. It is not present in A. So, you have to write A. See here, A minus B value is 4, 9. B minus A value is 8. Both are not equal. Did you understand? Next. I will give one sum. We'll write a different set of. We will perform the operations on the set. All the operations will perform. It belongs to B. A is equal to 3, 5, 8, 9. B is equal to 7, 6, 8, 9. First we will do A union B. What is A union B? A union B means what I told, it should present in both the sets, any set. Both the elements which are present in common elements you have to take only once. 3. First write 78. 7. 7 is not there. So now no right elements are set 3. 6. 6 is also not present. 8. 8 already we wrote. 9. 9 already we wrote. So this is A union B. Now A intersection B means what? It should be present in both set A and set B also. It should present in both the sets. Which elements are present in both the sets? 8 and 9. See, 3 is present only in set A but does not present in B. 5 is present only in set A, does not present in B. 8 is present in both the sets. 9 is present in both the sets. Now A minus B. A minus B means what? We have to take the elements which are present in A. We should not take the elements which are present in B. So it's 3. 3 present in only A. 5. 5 is present only in A. 8 is present in A and B. So we should not take. 9 is present in A and B. We should not take. Now B minus A. B minus A means which is present only in B. Not in A. So take B. 7. Is present only in B. 6 is present only in B. 8 is present in both B and A. So you should not take. 9 is present in both B and A. You should not take. So these are the 4 main operations. Did you understand? So we have to complete the exercise 2 based on this sums, based on this model. Did you understand, children? Tomorrow we are going to discuss about Venn diagrams. Thank you.